Hey everyone, welcome back to CNATD channel. Today we're going to walk you through the process of changing your Microsoft account to a local account in Windows 11. In another tutorial linked above and in the description, we demonstrated the differences between a Microsoft account and a local account and the advantages of each in Windows 11. Before starting the training, we'll explain the advantages and disadvantages of switching from a Microsoft account to a local account. Whether you're looking for a bit more privacy or just prefer not to use a Microsoft account, we've got you covered. So let's dive right in. Advantages of a local account. When you use a local account in Windows 11, the amount of information sent to Microsoft servers is significantly reduced compared to when you use a Microsoft account. Local accounts are considered offline accounts because they don't require an internet connection for configuration or use. If you want to sign in quickly without a password and aren't concerned about unauthorized access to your computer and its data, the local account offers this capability. When you log in with a local account, your settings, files, and preferences are stored only on that particular device. This type of account is useful if you want to maintain privacy or if you don't want to tie your Windows experience to an online account. What happens when you switch from a Microsoft account to a local account in Windows 11? When switching from a Microsoft account to a local account in Windows 11, you lose access to several online features and functionalities, including Settings Sync, your personalized settings such as themes, passwords, and language preferences won't sync across devices. Windows Hello. Some features of Windows Hello, such as facial recognition and fingerprint sign-in, might require a Microsoft account. Family safety, parental control features, and activity reporting require a Microsoft account. Microsoft Rewards. Access to Microsoft Rewards points and benefits is lost. With a local account in Windows 11, you can still access the Microsoft Store, OneDrive, Outlook, Xbox app, and Office 365. You can easily log into each of these applications individually. Change Microsoft account to local account in Windows 11. Right-click on the Start button and select Settings or press the Windows logo key together with the I key on your keyboard. In the Settings window, you'll see a list of options on the left-hand side. Click on Accounts. In the right pane, click on Accounts. Under the Account Settings section, click on your info. To quickly access this window, you can open the Start menu, click on your username and select Change Account Settings. Under Account Settings, you'll see an option that says Sign in with a local account instead or Stop signing in to all Microsoft apps automatically. Click on that. A new window will pop up explaining what happens when you switch to a local account. Click Next to proceed. Now you'll need to verify your identity. Depending on your setup, this might involve entering your Microsoft account password or using a method like two-factor authentication. Enter your credentials and click OK or Next. For example, we have already enabled a PIN to login into Windows and now we enter the PIN. Next, it's time to set up your local account. Enter a username and, if you want, a password. Remember, the password is optional but recommended for security reasons. The hint should be a subtle reminder of the password without giving it away to others. After filling out the necessary information, click Next. On the final screen, you'll see a confirmation message. To finalize the switch, click on Sign Out and Finish. Your PC will sign out of the Microsoft account and you'll need to sign in with your new local account credentials. And that's it. You've successfully changed your Microsoft account to a local account. It's a pretty straightforward process, right? If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to CNATT channel for more tech tips and tutorials. Also, if you have any questions or need further assistance, drop a comment below. I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Happy computing!